Hi guys. This is the final video of 2021, so I'm just gonna be wrapping up the year with a reflection on what happened in 2021 by looking back on my resolutions for the past year and see how many of them I actually completed, and setting my resolutions for 2022. This is something that I've been doing for a few years already, but the first time I'm putting it onto YouTube, so. I think these resolutions are pretty important to me because something pretty core to me is my desire to keep on improving myself, even though half the resolutions I never get done, but it's okay. But yeah, I'm just gonna get right into it. Okay, so these are my 2021 resolutions from the previous year. I think something that's been a pretty big thing in my life that I've been struggling with is number one, confidence. Number two, knowing when my opinions are valid, because I think for the longest time in high school, I used to be really opinionated and spoke out a lot, which I now recognize as one of my core personality traits, and that makes me me, you know? But I think before, when I was trying to improve myself, I identified my opinionated trait to be a source of problems. So I really tried to like mitigate my opinions by seeking validation from other people that they have similar opinions to me, because I didn't want to overbear with my own opinions. And as a result, I kind of went to the opposite extreme, to where I lost touch with my opinions and kind of sought validation from other people, and other people's opinions started to shape me instead. In 2020, I started recognizing that as a problem as well, and I was like, okay, I need to regain touch with my own opinions. Like, not everything has to be validated by other people. That's why I had a resolution of being unapologetic in what I want instead of caring about what other people want, and also gaining confidence in my expressions. This included both my physical expression, like my appearance and the clothes I wore and the makeup I put on and stuff like that. Another aspect was that of gaining confidence in the expression of my beliefs, because in 2020, I think something that was really big was a lot of social issues being talked about online, and combined with my need for validation from other people, I was thinking, okay, I need to start reconnecting with my own opinions, right? And on top of that, something that's consistently shaped the way I view the world is seeing things through the lens of social status. I've only in the past few years started to see that as something that I want to change. Like, I would categorize people based on their social status, and I would associate worth with that. And I kind of think that that perspective came from my parents, and I've just encountered different experiences where I'm like, oh, okay, this person has so much more value than I originally gave them credit for, because I just associated their value with their social status. And that kind of sounds bad, but like, that's kind of just the way it was, and I wanted to change that, obviously. And those three bullet points I just covered, over the course of 2021, I've definitely improved a little bit, but I'm not 100% there yet. So those are still in progress, but I think I did improve on them just because it's something that consistently affects me in my life and I want to improve. The fourth thing was I wanted to be a better listener and more receptive to criticism and outside perspectives. I think I can completely check that off my list. Like, I completed this during 2021 because that's kind of one of my core values now. I try my best to listen to everyone first, and I really let other people's perspectives influence my overall worldview the past 2021 year. Again, I think those gave rise to the problems that I mentioned earlier. So those were my personal development resolutions from 2021. And something I also really wanted to focus on after 2020 was building my YouTube channel, and I made the goal of posting a YouTube video at least once per month. I really failed that. I think I was doing pretty well in the first half of the year, but I started pledging for a business frat and that got really intense, so I did not post for like 3 months. But that's okay, because I think I did build up my YouTube channel a lot in the past year, and I have learned a lot of different things, like how to edit. I got Final Cut Pro the past year. I think I can sufficiently and more quickly edit videos now, and I also know which programs to use to like create those little doodles on top or add whatever creative things that I come in my mind, which is great. So I think that really speeds up the learning process, and I definitely improved a lot over the past year. So even though I didn't technically complete this resolution, I think I achieved the same growth that I wanted to see. Yeah. I also really wanted to understand Korean at this time last year, and that kind of became not really high priority to me throughout the year, because number one, a lot of my high school friends are Korean and they would talk in Korean conversations sometimes, so I wanted to be able to understand what they were saying. But as I went to college in person, a lot of my friends now are Chinese. So I don't really have that need to understand Korean anymore. And I also wanted to understand Korean because throughout quarantine, I was watching a lot of BTS reality shows and stuff like that. and I wanted to be able to understand without subtitles, but I don't really have time to entertain myself with K-pop anymore, so this isn't really a priority for me anymore, which is fine. And finally, don't get corona, I achieved that, woo. Oh, ignore me holding this, I just got my booster shot. But yeah, that was my 2021 resolutions. I didn't really complete most of them, but I think that's okay because most of them are not checkboxes you can just like check off. It's like a process, and I think I grew sufficiently in those. Now I want to move on to some of the main lessons I learned in 2021. Number one, I really learned that I have to prioritize my time for the people and the goals I want in my life. Especially for relationships, I realized that I was really caring too much about what every single person in my life thought, and I like really wanted everyone to like me, and I didn't understand why I didn't vibe with some people, and I was like, oh, is there something wrong with me because these people don't like me or something like that. It seems so obvious now, but I just don't have the time to put into having solid relationships with every single person in my life. And genuinely, there's just like different people that are meant to be in your life, and it's okay that I'm not like best friends with everyone. In that sense, I'm really realizing that I can identify exactly what people are valuable to me and just put more time into them, and it's not necessary to create this type of relationship with every single person I know. So yeah, I don't know, it really seems obvious now that I think about it. I mean, it's obviously not that easy in theory, right? Like, everyone wants to be liked. And I also had a lot of interests that I wanted to pursue in 2021. Like, there was a lot of clubs I wanted to do, a lot of aspects of myself that I wanted to explore, but I kind of realized that I don't have unlimited time, and even though theoretically I could manage my time well enough to get everything done, it might come at the expense of my mental health. Like, I wanted to do this sustainable fashion club, as well as e-board for this cultural club, as well as pledging for business frat, and then like I just couldn't handle it all and have enough sleep and also pursue my personal projects like doing YouTube or researching crypto or that type of thing. I just realized that I had to prioritize the things that I really want to do and not overload myself. I think this is also something that I'm gonna have to put into effect in the next year or two, because there's still a lot of things I really want to do. But number two, I talked about this earlier, but I learned that my feelings are valid. A lot of times I was questioning myself, like, why do you feel this way? Like, especially being on college campus for the first time, I was having a lot of struggles socially, like finding the people I connect with, or wondering why I didn't vibe with these people, or why I couldn't maintain these conversations or relationships. And I also struggled with feeling like a failure sometimes, because I was like, oh, you should be better, you should be able to handle these things or get everything done. I kind of realized that I was being a little hard on myself, and it's valid to go through these struggles, because obviously I'm only a human being. I'm literally 19 years old, and like, I don't have to do everything perfectly. I think this type of mindset kind of came from being an Asian immigrant child. Parents always expect you to just like keep your head down and get through everything, and I think I'm realizing that this Asian immigrant mindset kind of just throws feelings to the side and push through every hardship, but I realize it's valid to feel things. Kind of just building off of that, I also learned that some things are a process. My mindset's kind of like analytical, and oftentimes I find myself breaking down like all my little issues or struggles and trying to find the core problem, solving that problem so I can solve my issue, right? I kind of realized over the course of this year, and especially pledging, that some things you just can't solve immediately, even if you know the core of the issue. Sometimes things just take time to figure out themselves. I need time to grow, and that's okay. My last big lesson from 2021 is that I should not sweat the small money. I don't know if that's the right expression, but I used to be pretty stingy with my money. Like, I'd be that type of person that got kind of pressed over those few cents and change. I'm that person. I learned it really doesn't matter that much. Those few cents or few dollars are not worth the strains it can put on your relationship sometimes, and those few dollars are worth the extra happiness it can bring sometimes. I also recognize that this comes from a place of privilege, and I'm really grateful for that. But yeah, I just feel like in this stage of my life, I do want to prioritize my happiness and relationships, and with the privilege I have, this is the best type of decision for me to make. I was also talking to one of my friends about like the struggle having between saving money versus prioritizing the relationships and happiness. He was like, this sounds kind of stupid, but why don't you just spend that time focusing on how to make more money instead of trying to save money? And I was like, that's genius. Like, it's so obvious, but it's true, right? So that's something that I want to live by now. That's a perfect segue into my 2022 New Year's resolution. I think going into 2022, I want to be a lot more career focused, and this includes starting to build some income for myself. I think a big aspect of building my career next year is gonna include building these character traits for myself. And number one is I want to learn how to cement habits into my life. Something that I've been consistently struggling with for the past few months is cementing habits in my life, like consistent exercise or having a healthy diet or posting on a consistent schedule. So I want to work on implementing habits into my life that help me improve my overall lifestyle that will position me for success in the future. So I think that'll encompass like all the new goals that I have over the next few years. Something that I'm realizing is a really good skill I need to have that I don't right now is my ability to communicate. Number one, like I've spoken in front of people. Oh my god, it's so bad. I've spoken in front of people, like public speaking basically, and I've just froze. Like my brain just couldn't work anymore. I really, really want to be able to have enough practice in order to be able to speak and convey myself clearly rather than just like freaking freezing. Oh my god, it's so embarrassing. Also, sometimes I feel like in social situations, I have trouble like speaking what I really want to say. So just overall communication, I think that's really important, especially as I'm a business major. My ability to speak and appear confident is really going to impact my level of success that I can have, I think. So that's that for personal development. After looking back on last year's, I thought that having too many personal development goals might be kind of unrealistic. So, and realistically, I don't think I'll be able to completely achieve these. I might be able to learn how to put these habits into my life, but I don't think I'll be the world's best speaker by the end of 2022. It's just a process that I want to keep on going through this next year. Moving on to my career resolutions, I have a few interests that I want to take action on. First and foremost, I want to start earning one stream of income in the next year. This is open to whatever like opportunities come my way or whatever ideas I have. I want to end the year having at least one consistent stream of income. I guess this resolution directly pairs with it, but I want to get monetized on YouTube. I'm already halfway there with subscribers, which is nice. And I just have to figure out how to get 4,000 watch hours within the next year. Then I'll be able to be monetized. And I think by focusing on my YouTube channel as one of my bigger career goals for the next year, this is something that is feasible. So I'm gonna work towards that. I've also just increasingly been interested in music. And over the past year, I kind of discovered my passion for writing poetry. Like poetry, it's not like professional freaking haikus or whatever, but I just write down my feelings and that type of thing. And I've started writing some things that could potentially become lyrics. I really want to produce just one song over the next year. I feel like it's not that big of a reach. I just have to refine my lyrics a little bit and come up with a tune and learn how to use music production software. And then I should be able to create it. And I have a lot of people around me who I think I can reach out for help if necessary. So yeah, I think I can complete it as long as it's still something that I prioritize in the coming year. And on top of that, I've been interested in cryptocurrency, but I'm not immersed enough in the space to actually continue researching. So with my background as an artist, obviously hearing about NFTs and how they're gonna be like the technology of the future or whatever makes me want to create one of my own. And I think actively trying to do that will put me in the space more and make me want to research it more. Yeah, that's something I have to do by then. That's it for my career objectives. If I achieve all of these, I'll be really, really happy with my progress. And moving on from that, I just really want to get my pull up. My split means I exercise enough to build up muscle and also maybe lose a little bit of weight to make the pull up easier. And also that I'm working on my flexibility to get the split. I think if I can do that in the next year, then I'll be at the point where I'm satisfied with how physically fit I am. Lastly, I know I just said that one of the lessons I learned was to not care about the small monies, but I do think I'm spending a little bit too much. So I want to just track my expenses so I'm conscious of exactly how much I'm spending. And I think this is part of also being financially literate. Obviously, even though I'm willing to spend money for my happiness and fun, I'm not gonna just like completely lose sight of exactly how much I'm spending. So yeah, those are my main focuses for the next year. And I really tried to make my resolutions something that I could feasibly achieve. I guess next year there'll be an update about how it goes. I really like New Year's resolutions because it's kind of just a tradition for me, and it gives me kind of a time to reflect and also look forward on my progress in life. It's honestly gratifying seeing how much I've changed over the years and improved as a person and matured, I guess. So I really do recommend setting feasible New Year's resolutions and looking back on your old ones. But at the same time, I don't think New Year's is the only time you can set resolutions. Like, I think throughout the year, we should consistently be trying to improve ourselves and setting goals for ourselves to achieve. But yeah, if you guys want, comment down below something you've learned this past year or a resolution you've achieved or your resolutions for the next year. And I'll like encourage you, and we can all be motivated to be better people together. Yeah, but thank you guys for watching, and Happy New Year's. Bye.